Oh yeah, so in today's video we're looking at a Pioneer AV amplifier, and this is a VSX920 I think, and anyway it's had a number of messages coming up on the screen which are to do with overheating. So the question is though, is it actually overheating or is it a false reading? Now people out there are trying various things, I believe, resetting etc, or trying to reset the system. So but does that really work? So what's wrong with this thing, I hear you ask? Well, apparently some months ago the user said that they had to perform some kind of reset on it, and then it was stable for 3 or 4 months, and then more recently it was saying that it was overheating and then shuts itself down. So yeah, so basically I think the best thing to do is power it up and do some monitoring, but it's a bit awkward because they say it's very variable. It can be as long as 4 hours before these messages appear, but I'm hoping something will show itself. Right, so there's actually a little bit of catch up to do now, because there's a couple of little things I did and forgot to record it. Oops. But anyway, I noticed the thing failing pretty much as soon as I switched it on. So, you know, with the amp failing, sorry, amp overheating sign on the front. And yeah, so first of all, I set about trying to find a direct replacement component for the what they refer to as a positor, which was new to me. Basically, it's a thermistor, so of a specific temperature coefficient. Anyway, of course, the standard parts are you can't get for love nor money. Pioneer became Onyx or something like that. And they didn't bother getting back to me about a replacement part, so I assume they either didn't want to know or didn't have it. So next thing was, let's try and find a as close equivalent as we can find, because I mean, in theory I could just pop a resistor in there that is the same cold temperature, if you like. But then if there was an overheating problem, a genuine one, I wouldn't want this thing getting hot and causing a serious problem, if you catch my drift. So so I set about trying to find a work out what was the closest equivalent I could find, simply by starting out to use, well, I don't really need to show you, but somewhere around here I connected a a potentiometer. Ta-da! I'm sure you all know what a potentiometer is. Ridiculously over the top, because it's a 10k, but because as it turned out I only needed around 300 ohms. Now the connector fits deep dark into there. I think hopefully you can see that, where I've got my little tails attached. And so yeah, I tweaked it to around about 10k, 300 ohms, and powered it up. And ever since that point, many turnings on and off, I didn't observe any extreme uses of current, which would show you that it was overheating. As you can see on my little thing, it's just gently glowing at the back there. And no messages of complaint at the front so far. So so then I ordered a thermistor to do the same, plug it in there, see what happens. I mean, obviously, it's not actually touching the heatsink, which I've got to figure out a way of mounting it on there, because, you know, it needn't be. It's not even gonna. There's no way to directly fit it to where it was anyway. So I'll just figure a way out of doing that. Obviously, to protect these leads so they can't short out to anything. But anyway, it's not still not showing any faults, so I'm fairly confident that we are about there, really. So I'm going to set about fixing that in there nicely, heat shrink over those wires and hook it up, put it back together, and hopefully we're there. I mean, I'm hopefully the well, I'm sure if the customer had any more problems, they would soon get back to me. They're pretty local, so we can pretty much sort that out. But there you go. So there's not an awful lot of information on this online, by the way. I did have a look. Yeah, a bit of waffle and nothing very useful. But there you go. This seems to be a common issue. And I know some people have found videos where they would perform a reset and it seemed to get them out of trouble temporarily. But it seems like the original component with age, they were just failing left, right and centre. So if you come across one of these, that's going to be your go-to if you get those error messages coming up. Okay, obviously it's quite a quick and easy thing to change as well. Highly recommend you try that first. Anyway, here we go. So here we are, it's powered up again. I've lashed it together a bit nicer with some heat shrink in there, and I've connected it to the back of the heat sink here. It's not right down in there like the other one was, but I mean, if it gets warm, it's going to get warm, the whole thing. So I don't think it'll make any difference, to be honest. I've put a little blob of glue on there just to hold it in place. Same on the connector at the bottom, so nothing pops out. And as I say, anything can be removed if it needs to be, but also, of course, I connected the thermistor with a bit of heatsink compound, so it makes a good thermal contact. It's basically kind of wedged in there under that screw, so it's touching everything relevant, as the old one was. So I think we're gonna put the lid on and ship this, and hopefully we're there. As I said at the start of all this, he did say he has been known to go 4 hours before showing a fault, which is not very useful, but it appears to be, you know, the fact when I first started testing it, it was playing up immediately. I think I've put it through its paces enough to that it would have shown itself by now. I've tried it all through the different inputs, selecting different inputs. I've cranked the volume right up so the amplifiers are working reasonably hard. Turn that back down now just in case it doesn't go, it comes up loud when he puts it in. And I've selected the speakers on and off on the output and not observed anything unusual. So I think we're gonna ship it, as I say, and if anything comes up, there may be a part two. Have it, fingers crossed, hopefully not. Again, thank you very much for watching as usual, and like, subscribe, comment, and if you've got any questions or if you're having to deal with anything similar, by all means drop me a line. I'm more than happy to have a chat, see if I can help. Other than that, we'll see you next time. Bye.